Hey guys and everyone, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to yet another video. Thank you so much for coming. Kindly subscribe, like the video and share it as well. Don't forget to like, you guys, and also put your notification bells on and also watch those ads when they come during the video. Kindly let them run, it does help a lot. Now guys, let's talk about this bold thing this bold thing between South Africa and Nigeria, these fights that are happening, you guys. All these fights in Impera, are they necessary, you guys? Are they even necessary? And this South Africa and Nigeria thing, didn't this start with Dawuga Chidima and all that is escalating and escalating? I've seen those fights on Twitter. Let me just say everyone on social media, like it's South African and Nigerian, South Africans and Nigerians. For any, you guys, like for any, Mara Awa. So now there's this bold thing, Uber drivers, Babizama Uber and canceling them just in to. It's like an Uber driver, it's like umuntu se South Africa, like abizi Uber that side in Nigeria and cancelling, or mhlambe se Nigeria abizi Uber this side and cancelling, just in to get back to those people, you know. Imagine mangabe you're an Uber driver and then you drive to a certain place and that trip is just cancelled. Especially when you arrive at a destination, the petrol that is wasted and all that, you guys, is cutting that is wasted in the petrol and everything, stress and all. And all for what? What is the fight about? What are we fighting about? Uchidima, or is it something else? Because, wow. Angazi bafethu, now we bold kutwa it has now cancelled the cross-border ride request between South Africa and Nigeria. Bolt has disabled the inter-country ride request between South Africa and Niger. This is one of those you guys now na cool marking a lot about the bold. And this is ngempela the fights that are happening online. Ama Nigerians era na South Africans. Kiri for ing, kuba kwa ing. So let me see, trending South Africans here. This is PSAF Live. I got Twitter, but trending South Africans have started a new trend. They have requesting Bolt rides in Nigeria. Then Nigerian flathead Bolt drivers will go to location where the ride was requested and only to find out which no one is at the spot. This is a waste of their time and expensive petrol. This is what has been happening, you guys. Abantu babies are my Uber for nothing. I've seen those videos everywhere. I'm like, eh, niyabora, man. Niyabora. What's wala bora? For any. Hey, guys, no. The e-hailing trend that took place yesterday and affected Bolt in both South Africa and Nigeria has forced the company now to restrict the inter-country ride requests between the two African countries. This comes after videos and screenshots of the trend started making the rounds on Twitter with people requesting fake rides. It is alleged that the trend was started by South Africans pranking drivers and requesting rides as if they were in Nigeria, then cancelling the rides after keeping the drivers waiting for long. Can you imagine? In videos trending on social media, online users can be seen requesting rides and then mocking Bolt drivers after cancelling a ride they had ordered. On one screen grab, a South African requested a ride, and when the driver in Nigeria asked where exactly he was, he responded in Zulu and said he was at the popular Shisanyama in downtown Jobe kwa my mai. Ngiboni chat and yeti hi sating la kwa my mind ton ton nendao. Apalang si Zulu tributi. Which language are you typing on? Please write in English. You know what? Nigerians have hit back at this behavior by adopting the same tactics. They have also started requesting ama Bolt rides in South Africa from Nigeria, which has the same impact. This resulted in the e-hailing company restricting inter-country requests between two countries. Abona ke lapana ama let me see these screenshots, you guys. Yo, ile ibhalwe ngesiZulu ke kuthi I'm here, and then lwanuthi ensizweni ngisakhuphuka ngodla kwamayimayi inhloko lapha ngibese imbelesele ungilinde, something like that. Then I said, hello, where are you? I entered their premises. I said, pendula ngesiZulu, lathi ngithe ngila kwamayimayi man mfana ngena uzobamba nawe ithumbu, uzobamba nawe ithumbu. Then aphendule ke ngeEnglish athi you are not receiving your call. What language are you typing? Type in English. Waphendula wathi kodwa mungenawo uBrent uthi ukhohlwa ke omqhele. Hayi bafethu, this is not funny. And then aphendule ke lana, I don't understand this language. Athi ayi yabona ke manje mina ngisazi wakithi ngikhulele MC ngakelusa ngeqhathwa futhi. Hayi angazi bafethu, ama-chat laphana, the Nigerian person is writing in English, this guy is responding in Zulu. Uthi brother, there is no road to what? Oh, uthi my brother, I'm here and there is no road to come inside. Brother, I'm in front of the mosque or something like that. And then Lava said, no road to come in. And then Lava said, I'm just texting my app. I'm here in South Africa. I'm not going anyway. Lava said, are you serious right now? And then Lava said, yeah, fuck you, man. And then Lanabe said, with the present condition of fuel in Nigeria. Then there was a pin that I don't care for sec. Ay, bafet marai. I know this is a no. Hi, geke bafet. Ukutwagi Bolt said in a statement that the company was aware of fake right requests and blocked users who requested such rights on their platform. Did I say blot? Bolt is aware of the fake right request incident between some people in Nigeria and South Africa following a thorough investigation and the implementation of enhanced security measures. We have addressed this issue swiftly by restricting inter-country right requests. The company said that they understand the situation has impacted drivers in both countries and that they are committed to ensuring a safe, reliable, and secure experience for all community members. Those responsible for this malicious activity have been identified and held accountable by blocking them from the Bolt app. You'll never ever have to use a Bolt because, guys, wow. I wanted to go through this. I'm a screenshot lawa. I can't open. If you can just allow me to open there, you guys are on Twitter. There's a lot of drama because of PSA, what live, you guys. I seem to can't go there. But anyways, you guys, this is just some nonsense that is happening in Bolt. Perfect, awukwazi ukubiza Bolt and we are ukuthi awukho lapho ngase Nigeria. Ay, perfect. Nenzani kodwa perfect. Ama fights, what are they for? My question is, guys, what are we fighting for? What are we fighting for? Let me see. South Africans have started a new trend. They've been requesting Bolt rides in Nigeria. A Nigerian's flathead Bolt drivers will go to the location where the ride was requested and find no one at the spot. Imagine the waste of their time and expensive petrol. This trend has Nigerian, what Jollof cursing South Africans. One Nigerian said, I doubt if they were created by God and not the devil before he was casted out. They are so vile and wicked. Asho Abba South Africans, this amuses South Africans as Nigerians are well-known scammers and have destroyed many lives and businesses worldwide. This is the screenshot that I just read, guys. I was trying to go there on Twitter to see this Bolt situation. Let me see. But anyways, let me just cut the video here. Maybe we're going to do a separate video about this issue. Let us not let the video to be long. Oh, wow. And I suspect this whole thing started ever since Kwaba no kunga warning a soling apart, which is Dima and all that. Unless there is something that else that I do not know. But ever since Kwaba njene, apart, which is Dima no kuti Nigerians, but she's South African, what South Africans, but no, she's Nigerian. Kwavele nje, ever since, there is a lot about South Africans and Nigerians online. So I'm like, Buffett, is it even necessary? Is it even necessary, Buffett? But anyways, thank you so much for watching this video. Say your thoughts in the comment section. What the hell is going on, you guys? And what are we fighting for? Please say your thoughts in the comment section. Like the video. Don't forget to put your notification bell on. And yeah, let us meet again on my next upload. Bye.